Ladies and gentlemen, we are approaching the bomb.
Glitterball. It's probably one of the expressions being used to describe this structure we're in. But personally, I find that this place, you know, it defies any kind of description.
I didn't know what it was at first. Someone said it looks like a rose from the sky, and then it was sections of a fish, and then I seen that big dog thing there, or whatever it is. That's stunning. It's a stunning building.
I've yet to look around the museum. But it is stunning. I mean, I've heard so many reports about, you know, the architecture, and we're here, you know, and we're looking at it. Like I said, I haven't been inside yet, but I can't wait to get in there and have a look around. Certainly, architecturally, it's wonderful.
Whenever I've been reading about it in the past, I wasn't really that impressed by it, because usually I kind of thought, this thing's probably going to look horrendous when you get there and see it and whatnot, but it's amazing.
The whole idea was, because the song was called Glitterball, what we wanted to do is to do something which, when we were coming up with an idea, various things that we came up with, but the main thing was this building, and because it is the biggest glitterball in the world, we thought it'd be a great idea to sort of work an idea using this, not as sort of totally obviously, but just have little bits of you know, the structure and things.
In terms of the music and the performances, we're very much, you know, it's our vision. But the videos, while you're doing it, you can't really see what's going on, and you're very much in the dark, which is difficult. So in other words, you're putting yourself in someone else's hands to try and, you know, capture or marry the vision of the song, if that indeed is the goal.
Unless you've got an absolutely cracking script where you know exactly what you're going to be doing acting, I think acting is hammy. If you're trying to act something that you're not, it comes across like that on video. I think the best thing to do is to be as natural as possible.
They're not something that I love doing, although this is, you know, the prestige and the honour and the whole hipness of being the first to work inside this amazing place is makes it that wee bit special.
This is an opening shot, and really what we want to first of all establish is a band performance, and also that it's something quite unnerving is happening. It's, what is that? What's happening? Sort of to try and sort of intrigue the viewer into watching the video.
Well, I think the record was pretty much recorded on the move. I mean, the whole thing about our band is that, you know, every time you put out an album, you're tempted to say that was a phase, or this was a phase, that was another phase. But Charlie and I, things are much more seamless than that. And we sort of began this band 20 years ago, really. We were on a hitchhiking trip when the idea, or you could say the sort of determination to see it through begun, and in some ways that trip is still going on.
I think we wanted to veer away from a rock element. That was just something that was think we're kind of bored with and a bit tired of them. And also a sort of return to many years ago when we were more sort of, you know, sequence based, just a bit more, I suppose, experimental, a bit more European, dare I say.
I can definitely feel some musical flashbacks, and in terms of the personnel, the fact that Derek Forbes is playing with us again and Mel is playing again, it does seem like, well, it does seem to have come some kind of a circle. But I think to go back and try and create the past, not only do I not really think it's possible, but it wouldn't have interested us. I mean, whatever we did is there, it's still there, you can still get the records or the CDs or whatever. And, you know, so much has changed. We have changed, every cell in your body's changed since, say, since we made New Gold Dream, or technology's changed, everything. But I suppose if you have a long history, there are certain themes that are always there, you know, the sort of genetics. And at different times, they, for whatever reason, make sense again. Maybe it's just the fact that they become fresh because you haven't been in that kind of territory for a long time.
We were hoping on nice sunny weather. Needless to say, when we came to see it, it looked beautiful and it did glitter. When we come here, ever since we've been here, it's rained.
Well, I suppose we knew it would be like this. I mean, we'll blame it on Charlie. He brings the clouds wherever he goes. In fact, I think I can't blame it on Charlie. I went once to Ayers Rock where there hadn't been any rain for 9 years, and the afternoon I arrived, it rained for 3 days. I don't think that our humour has ever come out in the music. I'm not sure why, but it just... maybe we take the music too serious, or, you know, more serious than we should. But the music always seemed very dramatic, and I guess the videos and the artwork and the stage presence would fit that bill. But thank God we've fun, because if you can't have fun doing this, there's really something wrong. And yes, sadly, fun isn't a word that's been used a lot in terms of Simple Minds, but it doesn't mean to say that it's not what we've been having.
What I was wanting to ask you is the logic behind working with different artists, and why, you know, particularly in this case, did you feel it right to wake me up at 2 a.m? Shouting, hello, wee man. I'd like to ask you one thing. Where do you get your sweaters?
I have a very, very good tailor who knits them up.
Who knits them up, yeah. Pop style for that.
Usually when they're walking along and he sees them, he says, that's a nice one, that'll do, Andy. That's a great all
the way. The real serious Simple Minds here.
War Babies is actually you could say, like, the story of a torn family, say, you know, the kid in the middle of a broken relationship.
It had a very lonely melody in it. There was also something uplifting about it as well, but something naive in the melody to me, something classical.
My favourite track is Tears of a Guy, purely because of the musical content, and I think it's a really good song. You know, it comes across well and it's dynamic. And it has the dynamics of Simple Minds. Oh, that's the tears of a guy.
Just really excited about getting on to the next stage in the video, getting it edited.
I think it's nice. I mean, there's so many good bits that we've got together so far, and sequences that we've seen and things like that. Not necessarily what we went out with, not the initial concept and stuff has had to change slightly, but we haven't lost shots, we just haven't had quite the same quality that we first imagined. But in a way, it's taken on its own character. And now when we get it into the edit, probably what we go in and say, right, it's going to look like this. And then you start doing it and think, Jesus, no, that looks so much nicer, or that's so much more relevant. All the sort of neon lights work so much better than we thought they would. And as long as it doesn't look too twee, it should work very nicely.
I think what we find quite hard to understand is that we're obviously not, and haven't been for a long time, the sort of new kids on the block, but the people that were making music when we were kids are still making it. So we're in this middling no man's land, too old to be the young guns, and not old enough to be the out and out rock legends. You know, I guess people like, I'm thinking of Neil Young and Lou Reed and such. They're the ones that really throw down the gauntlet. It's, for my part, it's easy to get by, and it's a pleasure to get by in the energy of youth, but to take it to that other level that these artists have done is quite incredible, and to see how they'll go through all sorts of peaks and troughs and deal with their music and deal with the ever-changing industry around their music is inspiring. And it's that we look to. I mean, compared to them, we're sort of, you know, thoroughly wet behind the ears, and indeed not yet fit to lace their boots. So that's the challenge.